Hello, this is Z from KECG El Cerrito, and I'm here with members of the El Cerrito High School Thespian Society. Would you like to introduce yourselves?
Yes. Hi, my name is Leah, and I am a sophomore.
Hey, my name is Anthony. I'm a junior.
Thank you for being here. Now, Leah, can you tell us about the upcoming play?
Well, the upcoming play is called 1718, and it will be shown at the El Cerrito High Main Theater / Auditorium, and it will be playing this Friday at 7 p.m. and this Saturday at 2 p.m.
Is there a price to get in, an entry fee?
There's a $5 recommendation for a donation, but no mandatory fee.
All right, and it's called 1718, and can you tell us a bit more about it?
Well, 1718, it's this kind of dramatic play that we found. It's kind of about teenagers just figuring life out, what they're going to do in the future, and how they're going to prepare for college.
And Leah, since the play is about teenagers, or rather high schoolers, does that mean the age demographic is mainly the same?
I would probably say it is. I feel like some younger audiences may be able to take away from it, but also there are some like mature themes, like the death of a lost one, issues around race in the LGBTQ+ community, among relationship issues. I would say it's definitely geared towards teenagers, but I feel like anyone can have a good experience watching it.
That's good to know. And with that in mind, would you say the writing in the play is like accurate to teenager lives?
Well, the concept that they talk about is very accurate. Like you said before, racism, homophobia, you know, death of a loved one. But the actual writing is, it's a little bit off. You know, these aren't really ways, I guess, teenagers would communicate, but it still has main points that, you know, teenagers talk about.
And can you tell us who your individual characters are in this production?
I play Scrummer. He's this kind of like, he's kind of stuck in his ways since middle school. Like, a little bit annoying, but, you know, you love him.
And how about you, Leah?
I play Tana, and she's interesting to say the least. She's known to her friends as sort of like a social justice warrior, and she seems like a good friend, but can definitely hold a grudge against some minor things.
Do you guys feel any connections towards these characters in how they relate to your personal life?
Well, I mean, at least for my character, I feel like I was definitely kind of like him in middle school. Like, you know, kind of stuck in the ways, like I said before. But, you know, obviously I've grown. I feel like a lot of people grow. And, you know, kind of. That's all I can say.
Yeah. For me, I would say I can definitely hold a grudge, but it's usually not against minor things. And, well, as you'll find it in the play, she sort of has, like, an interesting relationship with, like, the people she knows and her relationships. And I feel like that's very different from me. But sometimes, like, I'm just, like, at home, and, like, I'm just trying to be, like, hey, I'm acting like this sort of person. It definitely sort of sounds like what Tan is like.
Nice. It sounds like you guys both have, like, some difficulties, but also some sort of ease to playing your characters. Since you have this connection, I'm sure it's helped when it comes to rehearsing and memorization. But besides that, what would you say the behind the scenes of the production is like? Any set designs or details you'd like to we'd like to look out for during the show?
Well, the play takes place in a basement, you know, and this is very you know, basements. They're very dirty. A lot of boxes around. You know, your grandma's old couch. You know, it's very kind of a dirty mess. But we do have some nice things you should look out for. For instance, we reuse the one of the flats, which is just like a big piece of wood. It's painted like a brick, and we actually used that last year in a play called Puppy's Playtime that we made. So I guess, you know, look out for that.
anything to add, Leah?
Yeah, I would say just, like, seeing, like, the tech crew and Jesse just, like, work on everything. Like, it went from being just an empty stage to, like, hey, that actually looks like a basement. And so that was just, like, really cool to witness. And then just bringing down, like, all the props and some of the set pieces. Like, it really felt like it came together really well.
Sounds like it sounds like a lot of fun. And I'm sure lots of people will look out for these things. But I think that's all we have. Thank you for coming on today. And can you remind us one more time when and where this play is happening?
Yeah, it's on Friday, you know, February 10th at 7 p.m. and Saturday, you know, February 11th at 2 p.m.
All right. Then it's a $5 donation price, but not necessary for entry?
Correct.
All right. Well, thank you, Ann and Leah, for being on with us today. I can't wait to see this play unfold. Once again, I'm Z from KECG El Cerrito. Have a good day.